On my most recent video, a viewer called Feel the Click asked if I can make a tutorial on how I made those title animations. Well, this is exactly what you're gonna learn today, so enjoy. As you can see on the screen, I've already prepared my title, and the title I'm using and that you should be using too is the Textplus title. However, if you don't know where to find the Textplus title, all you wanna do is go up to your effects library in the top left corner, then go down to where it says titles, and then grab the Textplus title in the first segment and drag it over to your timeline, just like so. Then move over to the top right of your screen to where it says inspector, then go down to the text field and type in everything that you want to be displayed on the screen and give it the layout that you want. In this case, I'm gonna have three words stacked on top of each other. However, you can add as many words as you want to this title and as you can fit in the viewer. So the next thing, because we cannot customize each individual word from the edit page, we have to go up to where it says text plus and then move to the right where you can see the Fusion magic wand. And if you give this a click, this will load up the whole title in the Fusion page. And guys, this is just the Fusion page. This is really nothing to be afraid of. We're not gonna add any notes. We're not gonna shift any notes around. We're just doing the customization parts. So if you've watched this section for the fifth time and you still didn't understand it, well, there's another section added at the end where you can get similar results just right from the edit page. However, they lack in customizability, and I promise after watching this section like only one time you will get the idea and you can pull that off as well. I promise. Then move over to the top right of our screen to where it says inspector, give that a click to open it up, and now we have the exact same options as we had in the edit page. However, if we right click this text field now, we can choose character level styling, and what this will do is not only add a keyframe, but it makes us accessible to the modifiers tab, and this tab is crazy powerful. Now if you give this a click, you can only see the text field because we have to select the word or the letter that we want to customize, because right now I can only select my S from this and give this a completely different font if I want to, or I can highlight the whole word or multiple words and only customize those. So I'm gonna select my first word, then I'm gonna move over to my inspector and I'm gonna choose a different font. And in this case, I'm gonna use Montserrat and choose the font face. And this is gonna be black italic. From here, you have multiple different options. You can choose the color, size, tracking, whatever you wanna do. Now let's give this a different color. Let's go with black and increase the size just a little bit and increase the tracking. So this is looking good. But we want to customize it even more, and this is where the shading tab up in the top comes in handy. So give that a click, then you have select element one, but if you select that, you have eight different options. So you can add eight different shading elements to just the selected part of your text, which is pretty good. Now we want to stick to one, and what we want to do is just choose an outline. So under appearance, select the outline, and to this outline, we want to add a white frame. So go to select element number two, select enabled, and then by default, this will fill in the outline. However, we don't want that. We just want to have a nice rectangle box around this title. So under appearance, select this border fill. And again, by default, this is looking horrible. So we have to fix that with the level. And where it says character, you want to choose word or line. This will give us a nice white border. However, you can choose any other color that you want. Let's go with a teal. Let's say we're happy with how this looks. Let's go back to text, select our next word, which in this case is. Then again, give it a different font if you want to. Let's go with Montserrat once again, and in this case, we want to choose a thin. Then let's decrease the size just a little bit and move over to the shading tab, select the element number one, and just give it a different color. This is totally fine for this text. Now what I want to do is go back to text, select my third word, and I want to choose a different font. In this case, I'm going to choose a completely different font. I'm going to choose Unisense, and heavy caps is fine. Color, let's go with red. And what I want to do is increase the size just a little bit, increase the tracking, something like this. But now we want to customize this title just a little bit more. So let's move over to the shading tab, and under select element one, we want to go down to where it says shear and just give it some X shear. Then we want to hop over to transform, and under transform, you don't want to choose characters. In this case, I just want to choose words, and then go down to where it says rotation. And on the CX, I just want to rotate it up just a little bit. Something like that. It's looking pretty good to me. However, you can customize your own text the way you want it to look. So I'm happy with how this looks. You can go crazy with this. You can add as many shading elements to one title as you want to. But for this tutorial, this should do the job. So with this being done, let's go back to the edit page. From here, what we want to do first is shrink down our text in length, because the default length of this title is 5 seconds and that's way too long. So let's go with something roughly around half a second. And now what we want to do is duplicate this text as often as words are on screen. And in this case, it's 3, so we need 2 duplicates. And in order to duplicate something, we have to hold the Alt key, left click, and just move it over to the right, left, up, or down. And do this one more time to have 3 copies. Now if I hit play, this is awesome. This doesn't look awesome at all, because in the first title, we only want the first word to be displayed. In the second title, we want our first 2 words displayed. And in the third title, we want our first 3 words displayed, and so on and so forth. So let's go to the first title, give that a click, then move over to the inspector, delete everything except the first word, then move over to the second clip and delete everything except the first 2 words. And in a third title, do the exact same thing. In this case, I don't have to delete anything because I only have 3 words. Now this starts to look a little bit better. This is awesome. But now I have to match this up to my voice whilst I'm speaking. So I want the first word to start where I pronounce the first word. And my first word starts at around this point in time. So I'm gonna highlight all 3, move them over. Then I wanna go to the point where I start saying the second word, which is at around this point in time. Select the second words, move that over and increase my first title. Then I wanna go to the point where I start the third word, which is at around this point in time. All I wanna do is just, you know, shrink that down, something like that. And if we go back now, this is what it looks like. This is awesome. So that is how simple it is to create like flashy pop-up titles or flashy subtitles. But we can add more stuff to those titles, because that is the power of Textplus, not only the shading tab, but we can also add effects and transitions to those titles. And in this case, I just created an effect especially for those titles, but you can use that on any logo or any image or any other text that you want, except this regular text. If we go to effects in our effects library, you can see this pop up. And what we want to do is just give that a click and drag and drop it onto our first title. Right now, if I hit play, you can see that it comes in frame and that is a little bit slow. So give the first title a click, move over to the inspector in top right corner and select effects. And there you have the animation speed and an out animation if you want to have an out animation. If not, I'll leave the out animation checkbox unchecked. The animation speed works a little bit different. If you increase the animation speed with the slider, the animation speed will get decreased. So we have to decrease the slider to make the animation faster. And let's go with something 0.276, which is pretty fast. Then once we've done this, we want to select our first title, hit Control C, select all the other titles to paste the attributes. And in order to paste attributes, you have to hit Alt and V. So the paste attributes window will come up. If you want to just paste the effects, all you have to do is select fusion effects and hit apply. And this will just give a nice pop-up animation to all of those titles. This is awesome. But if you want to use that on titles, I suggest you use that when single titles are displayed only, because this will just look a little bit better. This is awesome. As I promised, it is that simple. And if you've made it this far in the video and you fully understood what I was talking about, then you have all the rights to click off this video right now, because there's probably not gonna come any more new information to you whatsoever. However, if you still think that you could need a little bit more help, or you want the easy version, that is coming right after this segment. And I'm not gonna do any outro on this video anymore, because I've interrupted this video way too many times already. So yeah, let's wrap this up right here. And for those of you who stay, enjoy the next version with just the text tool and not the Textplus tool. Put that onto your timeline. Again, type in everything that you want to be displayed on screen, create the layout that you want. And right now you can highlight the word that you want to customize in the text field. Choose a different font, something like this. Again, increase whatever you want to do with it. And again, then go on to the next word, give it a different font, give that a different color. Do whatever you want. But the downside of using this text tool is that you cannot add any effects to that. And you also cannot add like custom backgrounds and outline borders as you would have done with the Textplus title.